Hello and welcome to this episode of Denny's Tips. Today, I want to teach you a retouching technique that not a lot of people pay attention to. I'll be teaching you how to enhance the eyes by enlarging the pupils in Photoshop. The pupil size can apparently make your subject more appealing. In some places like Korea and Japan, it's quite common to find people buying fake contacts that make their pupils look bigger. There is also a study done a long time ago where they showed two sets of photos. They both are the same except that one had the pupils dilated. People prefer the photo with the dilated pupils, and when they're asked why, they can't explain it. There are a lot of ways to retouch portraits. Enlarging the pupils is just one of them. But sometimes the smallest part of your photo will have the biggest impact. So if you're interested, keep watching this Photoshop tutorial and I'll show you how it's done. For this tutorial, you should be working on a high-res photo where you can see the details in the eyes. So we're first going to start by making a selection of the pupil, and then we're going to enlarge it. In the toolbar, select the elliptical marquee tool. Zoom in really close into one eye like this. You want to be able to see all of the details while editing. To make a selection of the pupil, drag from the center of the pupil, and if you hold the Alt or Option key, it'll drag out from the center like this. Then hold on to the Shift key, which will give you a perfectly round circle. We have our selection, and to preview how it looks, let's fill it with white. You can do it quickly by pressing D on your keyboard to reset the foreground and background colors, and then pressing Ctrl or Command Backspace to fill it with white. The edges look quite hard, so let's undo the fill by pressing Ctrl or Command Z, then press Shift F6 to bring up the feather selection tool. This lets you soften the edges of your selection. Enter something small. Sometimes even half a pixel is good enough. Fill the selection again to preview it. And if it looks good, we can duplicate the layer. Before we begin transforming, it's a good idea to convert the layer into a smart object. So right-click on the layer, then choose Convert to Smart Object. Press Ctrl T or Command T on Mac to use the Transform tool. Then while holding Alt and Shift or Option and Shift, enlarge the pupils like this. When you're done, press Enter to apply the transformation. Zoom out and see how it looks. Obviously, mine looks way too big and unnatural. So I'm going to transform it back down like this. Now usually when you're transferring up and down like this, it's going to reduce the sharpness. But because this is a smart object, you can actually resize it as many times as you like and you won't lose any image quality. And that's just one reason why you should use smart objects whenever you can. Speaking of smart objects, here's another reason why you want to use it. If we look closely at the pupil, it's blurry and the noise detail became quite splotchy. We can fix this by adding some noise, which will artificially sharpen it. To do this, go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise. Zoom in so that you can see the details, and then adjust the noise like this. You want a noise pattern that's subtle and looks like something natural out of your camera. Now if your image is black and white, you'll want to checkmark the monochromatic option. This basically just makes the noise black and white. Otherwise, just click OK to apply the changes. Looking in the Layers panel, you can see that because we applied this filter onto a smart object, your filter became a smart filter, which is fully editable. You can double-click back on the filter to change the settings anytime you want. Another feature of smart filters is that you can double-click here to bring up the blending options, and you can lower the opacity from here. So I'm going to set mine to about 50%. Now the noise that we added has a very minimal effect to the overall image, and when you zoom out, you probably won't even notice the difference at all. This is just a technique that's catered towards high-end retouchers who care a lot about image quality and maintaining the consistent sharpness and noise level throughout the entire photo. Anyways, right now the pupil looks fake. It really looks like someone just painted a dot over it. To make it look more realistic, we need to restore the reflections. If you look closely at the eyes here, you'll notice that the reflections and catchlight has been completely covered by our fake pupil. If we change the blending mode to something like overlay, it'll look better, but you also get this double pupil effect. You can also see that the reflection has a color that doesn't look very real as well. So we're not going to use the overlay blending mode. we're going to mask it out with the blend if settings. Right click on the layer, then choose blending options. On the bottom here, you'll find the blend if settings. We're going to use the underlying layer here, and if we drag the white slider towards the left, you can see the reflections coming back. Right now the edges of the reflection are quite hard, so to soften it, hold the Alt or Option key, then drag the white slider towards the right. The slider will detach in half, and you can fade out the edges like this. Click OK to apply the changes, and we're done. It looks much more realistic once we restore the reflections. We're done with one eye, now it's time to work on the other eye. I'm going to go through this quickly because you already know the steps, but along the way you'll learn some pretty useful tips and tricks. First, I'm going to select the background layer and make a selection out of the pupil. Apply the same feather setting by pressing Shift F6. The previous setting that we used should still be here, so we can just click OK. Press Ctrl or Command J to duplicate the layer. Convert it to a smart object by right-clicking on the layer and selecting Convert to Smart Object. Press Ctrl or Command T for the Transform tool. Resize it to about the same size as the other pupil. If the pupil is extending past the eyelid, you can fix it by clicking on the Add Layer Mask button in the Layers panel, select the Eraser tool, and if your foreground and background colors are the default black and white, it should paint your layer with black. Now if you like to paint your layer mask with the brush tool, you'll need to swap the colors by pressing X so that black is your foreground color. Anyways, I'm going to erase very carefully around here. My brush hardness is set to 100% so that the edges look hard. And to soften it, go to the Properties panel and then adjust the feather setting. Compared to setting the feather in your brush settings, it's not that big of a deal. It's just good practice because it's always easier to blur something than it is to sharpen it back. Next, we're going to restore the noise, but first, make sure that you've selected back the layer by clicking on the layer thumbnail. Otherwise, if you have the layer mask selected, you're going to be adding noise to the layer mask and it looks like you're doing nothing. Go to Filter, Noise, Add Noise. Your previous setting should still be here, so just press OK. In the Layers panel, double-click on this icon here to bring up the blending options. Use the same opacity setting that you use in the other pupil. For mine, it was 50%. And finally, we're going to restore the reflections. You can just copy and paste the layer style by right-clicking on the other layer and selecting Copy Layer Style. Right-click back on the previous layer, then choose Paste Layer Style. The reflection is restored and we're done. So there you go, that's how you dilate pupils in Photoshop. One thing to notice here is that everything we did is not just non-destructive, it's fully edible as well. You can always go back to the layers and change the settings to anything you want. Here's what the image looks like before and after. So what do you think? Is it more appealing or is it not that big of a deal? Maybe it's a placebo effect. Anyways, I want to know what you guys think, so let me know in the comments below. Guys, thanks for watching this video. If you found it helpful, hit the like button. Also, if you want to learn some more portrait retouching techniques, check out this video that I made a long time ago on how to retouch skin in Photoshop. You're going to learn techniques such as using the yellow channel, frequency separation, dodging and burning, and more. Anyways, thanks again for watching, guys. I hope you guys have an awesome day. And if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button below.